This bridge separates Karujubu Division and Kabango Town Council. It was initially built using eucalyptus tree logs. Ever since the Saturday rains, children cannot go to school, and since it's the only route to a nearby school in the area and the health centers, it means more trouble.
Omanda gunu gutuyamba muno kutwara abana isomero abagenda kusaba kukora business zaitu kugenda mukatana ka kibona kugenda mu town ni gwo muhanda gwangino ogutukozesa
moka byango amusina tatu mimi yakakateka.
We are appealing to the locals to make sure that we do burungi bwansi. We again mobilize ourselves, we get logs so that our children can access the school and the community can be able to access health services and water instead of waiting for the government program, which may take a lot of time.
According to the locals, the bridge has been in a sorry state for decades.
Oja, mbili, tatu, paka wafala. Sisi tunalia wakati yote, wanakuja, wanaona mzuri, wanaongea mambo mzuri, wanamwaga sisi. Tutafungua macho wakati hiyo.
Kufika mwaka 2026. Apazali namna sisi kapeka.
The district leaders, led by the district chairperson, visited this bridge to ascertain the extent of the damage. District chairperson Cosmas Biaruhanga says the bridge was supposed to be reconstructed in 2020, but its budget was halted due to the COVID pandemic.
We were interrupted by COVID-19. We could not be able to proceed without this funding. But now, this time, the only hope is going to office of the Prime Minister to come and respond to this matter as a disaster kind of action.
The district engineer, Joseph Sunday, says the bridge needs a permanent solution of box culverts of 3 meters. That will cost the government 350 million shillings.
If we are to get a permanent solution, it can cost us not less than 350 million to work on this crossing here because of the volume of water.
Report by Joseph Paguma for the news in Masindi.